Hi guys, today I'm going to talk to you about special brushes in Photoshop. I'm going to start by showing you some examples first. Here's a random end brush I created. And here's some confetti. And then there are my favorite ones, which is these flags, or bunting, or whatever you call them in English. And then there's these scales for a fish that I created once. Here I'm going to show you another example of how you can use it. Here I have a little fish. I created a clipping mask, and I'm going to set the mode to multiply because it has the same colors, and I can just easily fill it in. Whoop. And it's way less work than if you would have to paint all the scales separately. Of course, I'm not putting that much effort in it right now, but you can make it really neat. So, how do you make one of these brushes? Start with a blank canvas in Photoshop, and I would suggest to make a new layer on top of that. And then you use a black brush, and you create a shape. This is going to be the shape that's repeated all over your brush. So this is the basis of everything, so make sure it works nice. Well, I'm not happy with this, and you need to be happy with it because otherwise your brush is gonna suck. Okay, I'm gonna make my brush a little bigger so I can color it in. So you could do this in color, but it wouldn't have any effect, except for that your brush won't be as opaque. The black parts are going to be opaque, and the gray or the colored parts are going to be less opaque, because a brush only has one color per tip. So if you would put multiple colors in here, it wouldn't show actually in your final brush. So if you are happy with what you've created, I'm just gonna erase a little part here. So if you're happy with what you created, I'm never happy. Okay, you go to edit and then define brush preset, and you can name it, go with blend or leaves, whatever. I think I already got a blend, so I could blend too. And it already shows up as in your brush. But as you can see now, it's not the kind of cool fern thing that we are going for. I'm gonna just hide this for now. My flow is now lower, but I want it to be up more, so it's nice and opaque. And then you open your brush menu. What is it called? Brush. You can also access it over here. And then it goes up. Yeah. And you go to the top one in the list, which is brush tip shape. And here's a little preview, as you can see. And you need to adjust the spacing a little bit so you can see what you're doing. Right now they're all like next to each other, which I don't want. I want it to be nice and aligned. So I'm gonna just adjust this a little bit, and then I put the spacing so that they are nice and like next to each other, but I don't want them to. Don't want them to touch. And you can make it wider or less wide by adjusting this or turning the whole thing with this thing. I'm just gonna leave it as it was and just do the spacing a little less. As you can see right now, I didn't make mine wide enough, so it's going to overlap a little bit, which is sad. I think I have another one which worked a little bit better. Wasn't perfect either. It's this one. And I'm just going to do the same little steps. And just like this. So now you see they still overlap when you do a movement. But we're gonna fix that by using the shape dynamics menu. I'm just gonna switch everything off for now, so it's back to the default, and you have to set the control of the angle, this one, to direction, and then you get, oh, I'm just gonna make my brush a little smaller, and then you get this cool effect that the plant follows your brush. I think it's not, the spacing is just a little off, so I'm gonna put them a little bit close together, just like this. And if you want some more variation in your brush, because now they're all the same, you can do flip X, and then some of them will be flipped, or you can adjust the angle jitter, which will make them a little bit random, and like the angle a little bit random, or the roundness jitter, which makes the roundness a little bit random. If you put it all the way up, you get this effect, which is not really what I'm after. So I'm just gonna put it really low. And the angle jitter is a little too much because they're not overlapping. So I'm gonna put it at 2%, which is way up. Or maybe I'm just gonna switch it off. Anyway. Something else you can do, which is set the control of the size to pen pressure. And then if you press lightly, you get small leaves, and you press hard, you get big leaves. As you can see now, it kind of makes the thing upside down. Like, I want to be able to make a stroke like this from the bottom to the top, but now the leaves will be upside down. So if I want to fix it, I go to brush shape and do flip X, no, flip Y, and then it's the other way around. I still don't like the how they attach. I think I need to turn this a little bit. But yeah, that's much better. Maybe I shouldn't have touched it in the first place. So yeah, it's nice like this. And then let's pick a nice green color like this, and we got a plant, but it's kind of boring that's all the same color, so let's change to that. Go, if we go to color dynamics, we can use pen pressure to control the foreground and background color. So what this does is mix the fore and the background color based on how hard you press. So right now, if I press really small, lightly, I get the blue. And if I press really hard, I get the foreground color, which is green. So the effect is that you can get really cool, like, gradiented leaves like this. And as you can see, this saves you so much time for if you wanted to have to paint every single leaf separately. You can just go whoop, 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 and you've got a nice little bunch of leaves. I hope you liked that tutorial, and you're gonna make some cool flag brushes yourself. Oh, by the way, one more important step. If you want to save your brush so you can use it again later, you go to this drop down menu under the brush and select this little square thingy with the rectangle, which is new brush tool set. And then you can give your brush a name, so I call it plant. And if you can press include color, so it remembers the color, but you could also check it off so you don't have that. And go okay, and now it's in the list, so you can select another one, like my favorite little flags. And then I can just go back to the plant one. I still have that one. I hope you liked it, and I'll see you next time. I might talk about creating patterns in Photoshop, or even doing little animations, because I really like Photoshop and I want to share my knowledge with you guys. Hope you learned something, and if you create something, please tell me, because it would be really nice to see how people use this tutorial. Okay, bye!